In this video, I will discuss about a few questions on the middle term splitting form and factorization method. Let us discuss the first one. X square minus ix plus 6 is equal to 0. Can you see here x square? Now 6x square, it is there. So can you write 3i minus 3ix plus 2ix? Why? Because when you take it as a sum, we'll get minus ix. But when you multiply, you should get the product of the first and the last. When you multiply, we'll get minus 6x square into I square. And I square is equal to how much? Minus 1. And so minus 6x square into minus 1 is equal to 6 plus 6x square, and therefore here minus 3ix plus 2ix plus 6 is equal to 0. Now one more thing we can say, x square minus 3ix plus 2ix minus 6 I square is equal to 0. Why? Because I square is equal to minus 1. So minus minus plus. So plus 6 will be remained as it is. And so now take it. This x as a common factor. X minus 3i. Take it here. What is common factor? 2i common. So x minus 3i left is equal to 0. So x minus 3i into x plus 2i is equal to 0. So if x minus 3i is equal to 0, so x is equal to 3i, and if x plus 2i is equal to 0, therefore x is equal to minus 2i. This is the solution set. Now let us discuss the second one. It is also almost the same. Now x square plus 7 ix minus 12, 4 into 3, 4i plus 3i. You remember, here is positive, so both must be positive. But when you are going to multiply, what will get? Minus 12i square or not? You see? Plus 7i, and 4i into 3i, will it be 12i square and minus 12i? 12i means minus 12. So this minus 12 and x will come together. So therefore, it will be x square plus 4ix plus 3ix minus 12 is equal to 0. When you add, you will get middle term. When you multiply, you will get the product of the first and last. And now, again, we can say x square plus 4ix plus 3ix plus 12 is equal to 0. And then 12i square, because I square is equal to minus 1. Then this together will take x common x plus 4i. And this together will take plus 3i common x plus 4i is equal to 0. And then it will be x plus 4i into x plus 3i is equal to 0. So if x plus 4i is equal to 0, therefore x is equal to how much? Minus 4i. If x plus 3i is equal to 0, therefore x is equal to minus 3i. And this is the solution of this two. And then let us discuss the another question. Now this, there is no I here, still we can solve. How? X square plus 4 is equal to 0. X square minus 4i square is equal to 0, because I square is equal to how much? 1. And so minus 1 plus, so 4 will be coming there. But there is a way here, x square minus 2i whole square is equal to 0. Are you able to apply a square minus b square? and a square minus b square is equal to how much? X plus 2i into x minus 2i is equal to 0. So if x plus 2i is equal to 0, therefore x is equal to minus 2i. And if x minus 2i is equal to 0, therefore x is equal to 2i. And now the other two questions we will discuss by using the completing square method, which you have already got the concept in class 10. Now let us see how to do. (17x²-8x+1=0). What is the concept of completing square method? We will try to first find out the perfect square of the first number. So either you multiply it by 17 or divide it by 17. Now dividing each term by 17. So (x²-8x+1=0). So x whole square minus 2 into x into this 2 divides this 2 divided by 8 by 17 2 into 17 by 8 4. So can you say here into (x²-2)(a)(b), we have to recognize b, and what is your b? 4 by 17. This is divided by, actually this, the this coefficient of this 8 by 17 is divided by the coefficient of this x by 2. So how much you will get? 8 by 17 into 1 by 2. So it is how much? 4 by 17. So 4 by 17 plus, so x (a²-2ab) plus (b²-), it is to be subtracted, whatever you have added is subtracted, and plus 1 by 17 is equal to 0. Then from here to here you have 4 by 17 whole square, a minus b whole square, and from here you take negative as a common factor, this will be 16 by 289 minus 1 by 17 is equal to 0. This will be equal to (x-4/17)² - now how much it is? 289, this will be 60 minus 17 left is equal to 0. (x-4/17)² - (1/289) is equal to 0. A square of which number gives you -1/289? You know, (i²) is equal to -1. So in place of (i-1), you can write (i²). And so it will be equal to (x-4/17)² - (i/17)² is equal to 0. Did you follow? (i²) means -1. 17² is 289. Now, is it in the form of (a²-b²)? And so it will be (x/14) plus (i/17) into (x-4/17)-(i/17) is equal to 0. If (x-4/17) plus (i/17) is equal to 0, therefore x is equal to 4/17 - (i/17), and so x is equal to 4 - (i/17). This is the first value of x. And similarly, if (x-4/17)-(i/17) is equal to 0, therefore x is equal to 4/17 + (i/17). So x is equal to 4 + (i/17). That is the another value. So this is what is the method of completing the square method. And now, same way, we can solve the third question. What is the third? (√2) फिफ्थ क्वेश्चन, रूट टू एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस एक्स प्लस रूट टू इज इक्वल टू जीरो। सेम वे वी विल डिवाइड इच ऑफ द टर्म बाय रूट टू, डिवाइडिंग इच टर्म बाय रूट टू, विल यू हैव एक्स स्क्वायर एक्स बाय रूट टू प्लस वन इज इक्वल टू जीरो, एक्स होल स्क्वायर प्लस टू इंटू एक्स इंटू नाउ वन बाय रूट टू डिवाइडेड बाय टू, सो वन बाय रूट टू इंटू वन बाय टू एंड देयरफॉर द बी टर्म विल बी वन बाय टू रूट टू प्लस वन बाय टू रूट टू होल स्क्वायर माइनस वन बाय टू रूट टू होल स्क्वायर प्लस वन इज इक्वल टू जीरो। एंड नाउ फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर व्हाट कैन यू हैव, एक्स प्लस वन बाय टू रूट टू होल स्क्वायर माइनस कॉमन वन बाय एट माइनस वन इज इक्वल टू जीरो। द स्क्वायर ऑफ दिस इज वन बाय एट माइनस आई हैव टेकन कॉमन सो माइनस वन विल बी देयर एंड हाउ मच इट इज देन, इट विल बी एक्स प्लस वन बाय टू रूट टू होल स्क्वायर माइनस माइनस सेवन बाय एट इज इक्वल टू जीरो। स्क्वायर ऑफ विच नंबर इज माइनस सेवन बाय एट, माइनस इज आई स्क्वायर, स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ सेवन इज इफ यू स्क्वायर इट द रूट ऑफ सेवन स्क्वायर विल बी सेवन एंड वॉट इज दिस, इट कैन बी रिटन एज टू रूट टू होल स्क्वायर, सो द होल कैन बी रिटन एज एक्स प्लस वन बाय टू रूट टू होल स्क्वायर माइनस रूट ओवर सेवन आई बाय टू रूट टू होल स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू जीरो। व्हेन यू स्क्वायर ऑफ दिस यू विल गेट एक्सैक्टली माइनस सेवन बाय एट और नॉट, वंस अगेन रूट ओवर सेवन स्क्वायर ओनली सेवन आई स्क्वायर माइनस एंड रूट टू होल स्क्वायर मीन्स एट। Now, is it in the form of a square minus b square? And when it is in the form of a square minus b square, we can go x plus 1 by 2 root 2 plus root 7 I divided by 2 root 2 into x plus 1 by 2 root 2 minus root 7 I by 2 root 2 is equal to 0. And then you can find out the values of x. If x plus 1 by 2 root 2 plus root 7 I by 2 root 2 is equal to 0. Therefore, x is equal to minus 1 by 2 root 2 minus root over 7 I by 2 root 2. And so, x is equal to minus common. It will be 1 minus root 7 I divided by 2 root 2. So this is your first value of x. Similarly, if x plus 1 by 2 root 2 minus root 7 I by 2 root 2 is equal to 0, therefore x is equal to minus 1 by 2 root 2 plus root 7 I by 2 root 2 and so x is equal to minus common, how much left? 2 root 2 1 minus root 7 I and this is the another solution. So the previous video and in this video together will give you the basic concept of quadratic equation. In next class, in my next video, I will discuss when the coefficients are involved by multinomials of the imaginary number, not only monomial but multinomial. Thank you. Next class we will discuss about the another method.